Today I will explain what is the difference between VA watt and VAR power. Here AC is written because these powers are applicable for AC source. This VA details are here, watt details are here, and VAR details are here. VA means volt ampere. This is also called apparent power. Watt is the unit of active power. This is also called real power. VAR means volt ampere reactive. This is called in brief reactive power. This all three power is calculated by multiplying voltage and current. See, formula is same. But then what is the difference? When current flows in a resistor, then unit becomes watt. When the current is flowing in capacitor or inductor, then after multiplication, we get volt ampere reactive power. When both are there, resistor and capacitor, or in place of capacitor we can have reactor also, like this. So resistor and capacitor or inductor, or this is also called reactor, if both are there, then the total current multiplied by voltage will give volt ampere or apparent power. VA is also written as a kVA, and 1 kVA will be equal to 1000 VA. Similarly, watt can be written as kilowatt, and 1 kilowatt will be equal to 1000 watt. Similarly here, VAR can be written as a kVAR, and 1 kVAR is equal to 1000 VAR. For bigger equipments, generally kVAR or kilowatt or kVAR used. In a smaller one, VA, watt or VAR are used. In house, we have energy meter. That one unit of the energy meter is equal to 1 kilowatt hour. This kilowatt is this power. But when we multiply power with the time hour, we get one unit. This is energy. This is power. Here one inductor is connected as a load across AC supply. And this is voltage and current plot and power plot. Blue is voltage, green is current, and red is power. These are not RMS value, these are instantaneous value. To get power, we multiply voltage and current. Current is shifted by 90 degrees. From here to here, when we multiply voltage blue color with green color current, this is negative, this is positive. So multiplication will come negative. So we get power like this. From this point to this point, voltage is positive, current is positive, so multiplication will come plus. Like that, here again, current is plus, voltage is minus. So multiplication will be minus. So red color will give power. Now you see this is one cycle. This is voltage. In this cycle, power have two cycles. Two times it goes positive, two times it goes negative. Positive means power is flowing like this. Negative means power is flowing like this. So power will be oscillating. It will flow like this, then it will flow like this. This is called the reactive power. Here, I have connected one resistor. Here, this is voltage and this is current. When we multiply voltage and current, here we get power. From here to here, current also negative, voltage also negative. If we multiply both negative, we get positive. So power is always positive in this case. So power always flows from source to load. No power oscillations are here. This is vector diagram of power. This is active power P. This is reactive power Q. This is apparent power VA, which is equal to square root P square plus Q square. Power factor PF will be equal to cos phi, where phi is the angle between S and P. This is also equal to P by S. This power P will be equal to S cos phi. This reactive power Q will be equal to S sin phi. Suppose we have S is equal to 1000, power factor is equal to 0.8, this is 1000. Then power will be S cos phi, S is 1000, cos phi is 0.8, it will be 800 watt. So this power is 1000, this power P is 800, so this is S is more than P. Or sometimes it will be equal also, provided this power factor is unity. Now, I have shown here 3. Here Q is this much. In all three cases, P is equal. If we reduce Q, value of S is coming down. Here Q is further reduced, the value of S come down further. This is almost equal to P. Now, suppose we reduce Q further, we make 0. So this angle will be 0. So cos phi, phi is 0, cos phi will become 1. Now this one is suppose 1000, power factor is unity, then this power will be equal to 1000 cos phi. Cos phi is 1, so 1000 to 1 is equal to 1000 watt. So if Q is 0, this apparent power VA will be equal to active power, both are equal. This is called the unity power factor. Here I have connected two load across AC. This is resistor, this is capacitor. This can be inductor also. Suppose voltage is 100 volt and current flowing in this 10 ampere, then power across this P will be 100 into 10, voltage into current will be 1000 watt or 1 kilowatt. This is active power. Here, also suppose current is 10 ampere, voltage is 100 volt, voltage into 10 ampere is equal to 1000 VAR or 1 kVAR. So this is active power, 1 kilowatt, this is reactive power, 1 kVAR flowing here. Now, total power here will be square root, square of this plus square of this is equal to 1414, if you calculate it will come, or 1.414 kVA. Power factor will be P by S, P is 1000 watt, S is 1414, it will come 0.7. Current here will be square of this plus square of this under root, it will come 14 ampere. If we multiply this voltage with this current, again you get same figure. So this circuit has 1 kilowatt active power, 1 kVAR reactive power, and total VA power 1.414 kVA. Power factor is 0.7. So all three powers are shown here, active, reactive and VA. Here I have connected only capacitor or inductor, but here both are connected in parallel of resistor. Now suppose this also is 1 kVAR, this also 1 kVAR, then reactor and capacitor will always cancel each other, their nature is opposite in nature. So there will not be any reactive power. We will have only active power of 1 kilowatt. Power factor will be 1. that is called the unity power factor. This is similar circuit. Just now I have shown, this is input 100 volt. This is a DC load with 1 kilowatt power. This is capacity load with 1 kVAR reactive power. And VA, apparent power, is 1.414 kVA. Active power, reactive power, VA. Now this is three phase circuit. This is connected across one phase line to neutral. Similarly, we can connect to other two phase, B and C also. So same power will flow in B and C also. This is neutral. Voltage is taken between line and neutral. So in three phase, total VA apparent power will be this plus this plus this, means three times. 3 into 1.414 is equal to 4.242 kVA. So in three phase, we calculate power for each phase, line to neutral, and then add all three together. So we get total VA of three phase supply. So far we were discussing AC supply. Now here it is DC. I have connected one resistor. Current flow is 10 ampere. Here again, power loss in this resistor P will be voltage multiplied by this current, 1000 watt or 1 kilowatt. But this is active power. Suppose we connect capacitor and reactor, then reactive power or VA are not applicable here. There will be only charging or discharging. Some energy will be required. During the charging, there will be some small loss. There is no concept of reactive power or VA power in DC. Only active power is there. Today we will close here itself.